Welcome to ZEISS INSPECT Correlate. In this video, I want to show you how easy it is to perform a 6 degrees of freedom analysis in ZEISS INSPECT Correlate. The 6DOF analysis allows you to evaluate the displacements as well as the rotations of your testing object. It's commonly used for evaluations of parts in wind tunnels, in biomechanics, materials testing, machine stiffness analysis, and crash tests, for example. If you want to try ZEISS INSPECT Correlate, take a look at the description below. There, you'll find links to download the software, request a free trial, and download training data. To perform a 6 degrees of freedom analysis, you need a project in ZEISS INSPECT Correlate that contains 2D or 3D images or video footage of your test. The testing object must feature reference point patterns. You also need to create one or multiple point components for your part, and the point components should be rigid, meaning the components themselves are not deformed. For more information about how to create point components, check out the video How to Perform a Simple Motion Analysis in ZEISS INSPECT Correlate. Please note that the 6 degrees of freedom analysis is best suited for 3D data coming from an Aramis system, for example. In 2D, you can only evaluate displacements in plane direction and the rotation around the out-of-plane axis. We'll be using a project containing 3D measuring data for a model excavator, 5 point components, one for each part of the excavator, the CAT data for the undercarriage, a local best fit alignment to the CAT, and an RBMC. If you want more information about a simple motion analysis or RBMCs, take a look at the video How to Perform a Simple Motion Analysis in ZEISS INSPECT Correlate, or look at the tech guide. Please note that I won't cover much of the theory behind the 6DOF analysis. I'm only going to show you how to apply it. For a more detailed explanation of how the 6DOF analysis works, is computed in the software, and so on, check out the INSPECT Correlate Aramis Basic e-learning. To perform a 6DOF analysis, all we really need is a local coordinate system. We can easily construct one in ZEISS INSPECT Correlate, but first, here's what you need to keep in mind. The most important thing is that you construct the local coordinate system in a stage without deformation, the reference stage. In our case, that's the first stage. Open construct local coordinate system by orientation. When you create a local coordinate system by orientation, you're creating the 6DOF analysis in reference to the global coordinate system. On a side note, you could also evaluate it in reference to a component-specific coordinate system, but we won't cover this here. Name the local coordinate system. Use Control and the left mouse button to click a point for the origin of the local coordinate system. Make sure you choose a suitable origin, as this affects the computer translation. Again, for more information, check out the INSPECT Correlate Aramis Basic e-learning. And you must tag the local coordinate system to the point component, in this case, superstructure. That means that the local coordinate system moves in the same way as the point component. Please note that the translation and rotations describe the movement of the whole component, not the point that's the origin of your local coordinate system. Then click Create and Close. Now all that's left to do is check the local coordinate system. To do that, open iInspect, either in the main toolbar or by using Control and the right mouse button. Make sure that the local coordinate system is selected in the 3D view or the Explorer. Then open Check and select the checks Displacement X, Y, and Z, as well as Rotation X, Y, and Z. You can display the results of your checks in the diagram to see them over all stages. create a report page, and maybe even include the diagram, and that's it. Quick and easy, right? As I mentioned multiple times throughout this video, please check out the ZEISS INSPECT Correlate Aramis Basic e-learning for a more comprehensive coverage of this topic. You'll find the link in the description below. If you want to know more about reporting, check out the video Reporting with ZEISS INSPECT Correlate. And in case you haven't watched them yet, check out the other videos in this starter guide.